We zijn live. Ja, Jung, you're next to me.
Hello.
Wait. Yeah, now we're online and this one is gone. If all is well. Hey, my microphone should be working.
Yes, I'm hearing you.
Yeah, you are, but.
Oh. If I can check on the.
Let me check. One second.
Yes, I'm hearing you, Jaap. Also on the live stream. Sorry for the technical interruptions, but as you see,
it is working.
Jaap and I are on different places right now.
Yeah.
So we have met some technical challenges, but I heard you on the live stream.
Okay. Yeah. We have so many microphones now attached that. Yeah.
It's okay.
Okay. We have so many microphones now attached that I didn't see the listing. That's it. But it is working. That's good. Let me explain why Jung is on a laptop next to me. My son had to be tested, so I can't be around people. And Jung can't sit next to me, so we thought, let's make a challenge, something nice. He's listening in on his big fat head monitor speakers. And he's in his studio, so he can actually hear what you guys are hearing during the live stream, and he can compare his experiences in the listening room with his feed over there. So he's showing you now very nice loudspeakers.
The reference model head it's introduced on last Munich's high end.
Yeah.
We must say it's quite amazing what these tall guys can do, because you know I'll show you the studio later. Okay?
Yeah. All right.
But let's do something first.
Okay. We have 7 amplifiers to test. I've made a listing from cheap to from less cheap. We have the NAD, the C388. That's a Class D amp. We have it without any modules, so it's 1800 euros or something around that figure. We have the Primare i25 Prisma. It's 2500 euros with streaming but without a DAC module. Then we have the Yamaha, the new one, the AS1200. We should do that one first before Primare, actually. Then we have the Denon 2500 NE. We tested it before. I think it's a very nice amp. Then we have the Advance Acoustic, or Advance Paris now. That's a little bit strange because it's a pre-amplifier power amplifier combination, and it's also 2500 euros combined. Then we have the Prima Luna. It's a tube amp. It's also around 2500 euros. And then we have, last but definitely not least, the Name XS3. It's the new one, Jung. It's a new amplifier. NAD is Class D. Primare is also Class D. Then we have the Yamaha Denon Advanced Acoustic. It's all AB, just like the name. And the only fully Class A is, of course, the Prima Luna with the tubes. But the Advanced Acoustic you can put in high bias, and then you have 45 watts in Class A. That's a lot.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah. Now you know why the air conditioning was running this morning. It's quite hot in here. Please let us know if you want to have us do something with these amps, like test tracks or I don't know, whatever you like. Just chat with us, then we can alter the live stream to your wishes. Jung, can you show us around in your studio a little bit?
I will. Wait a minute.
You're on full screen now. Then I'll grab my coffee, okay?
Yeah, good. Well, this is the Leiden New Plaat Studio. And this is one of the studios that's already finished. It's a school building. And it was, I think it's a science, so it was pretty high. And what we did was to make with the lowest possible budget and with all reusing materials, make a very good sounding studio. And actually, well, we're now on, I think, 1.5 years we're in business, and it's going pretty well. Here you see the Vox stereo amplifier setup. We have the Yamaha electric grand piano. What we did for sound improvement was to have these panel doors. For about a month, we have been looking in all, you know, what's it called, Kringloopwinkels, offal garbage cans to containers for these guys. But since they are so chaotic in, you know, in dents and in structure, they're very good in dissipating sound. Oh, this is a reference vintage JBL studio monitor Recon, sounding very well. Well, of course, we have also not only tube amplifiers, but there are also tube microphones. We have vintage microphones, new ones. And in the studio next to it, it's still being built, we have a very nice vintage Studer mixing console. Okay, and now we're listening to something very special, because I think it's not very, it's maybe the first in the Netherlands. Well, it's not maybe, it is the first in the Netherlands. They have Tower Mains, consisting of a center unit, a bass subwoofer unit on top and on the bottom, rendering a so-called Dapolito setup. Look it up if you want to know more about it. And for electronics, we have the already tested the Neve Fidelity DAC preamp, headphone amp, and the headphone, of course, because we're all head. And I'm listening just as you on YouTube. So this is kind of a Dolster effect.
Very
and,
nice.
Well, I'm very happy that we are very happy that it works. And it, the nice thing is that I can finally check if, because I know the studio in Haarlem pretty well, I can check how the sound, let's say at home or remotely, is in comparison to the sound in Haarlem in the Alpha Audio studio. So I'm very curious about that.
Me too. Me too. Well, thanks.
So we'll just do it as you were used to. We'll just be the two of us.
Yeah.
And but the difference is that I'm here and Jaap is there.
Yeah. Well, you're sort of next to me. I can give you a virtual hug. You're okay. You're. Well, he's on the left side of me on a table stand on a screen. So it's it's very nice. But let us explain. I have a microphone to the right side of me that measures the sound pressure in dB, so I can level all amplifiers. Well, I'll do the best I can. It's very, very hard to do it very precise, but I have a measurement. Okay, that's the Denon going in standby. Stay on. All right.
They all go standby.
Yeah, it's shitty, but
it's the green era, yeah.
Yeah, it's the green times. So I'll try to level all the sound levels as good as possible, because if something is louder, most of the time you think that it's better, but it isn't. So I'm trying to level all the stuff to -3 dB on my equipment, so that you get the most honest test that that we can deliver. We're fully transparent. I use tubeless single-ended interlinks. The reason I use single-ended is because not all amplifiers have balanced inputs, unfortunately, Jun. That's too bad. Then we use Dryade's flow, I think, or super flow. Well, something like that, speaker cable. It's new for us. I listened to it yesterday. It's very neutral. It's a very nice speaker cable, actually, and it's very flexible, and they're long enough. That's not unimportant, because sometimes I just have to go all the way back, and I'll show you. It's
is it Dutch?
Yeah, it's Dutch. Yeah. As you can see, there are a lot of amplifiers on there, and I have to reach all the way back to change some stuff. So, let's start out with the NAD, shall we?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll put off the mic.
Okay. We'll start off with No Sanctuary here from Chris Jones. And you can let us know which song you want next. I have an idea, but I'm gonna pick three songs per amplifier, otherwise we're not finished on the end of the day. And I'll try to keep it within 3 hours, but I don't know. Let's start off with Chris Jones.
Call for senses. The boss wanna know what's going on. So Joseph and Mary hit the road with Mary nigh on 9 months gone. And you know we're talking about a hell of a walk, and they had no place to stay. They tried the inns and the hotels, but the message was plain as day. You get no refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. No refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. Home, home, home. One had his one need up, and a baby boy they named Miguel. On the other side of the line it's heaven, on this side is a living hell. So you do what it takes, pick up stakes, and try to escape the drought. But when you get to the border, the INS, they got the welcome wagon out. You get no refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. No refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. Religion to preach about loving your brother, but they run.
All right. Well, Jung, you can come back now. This was the first song. I hope you liked it. Please leave a comment if the. Yeah, that's the feedback from the stream. I hope this was loud enough. And please let us know which songs you like. This is the René, this is the NAD 388. And Javier, you have caps lock on. So you type everything in big types. I thought this is good for the low end, you know? This is warm and should be punchy, and I still have two songs. I think Opera from Emmanuel is good for spaciousness. And we have, of course, our Bach song. Jung, your favorite.
Jacques Lussier.
Jacques Lussier. I'm going to start off with Opera now. And
maybe there was a question of René. He asked, which amp is this?
Yeah, it's the NAD C388. 1800 euros. All right, I'm going to start in Opera, and you can check that one out.
Thank you.
Well, that was the NAD C388, and it's fun to see all the comments in the chat. It sounds very well. It sounds much better than I was used to. It is a good amp, isn't it, Jung?
It is. I think it's very musical.
Yeah. It's better than I remembered. That's the fun part.
Yeah. It's. I think. Especially because it's a modular system, you know. The starting price is pretty, you know, okay, and then you can.
Yeah.
Upgrade it later on, so that's very neat and very nice.
Yeah.
And well, the first notes I took was musicality.
Yeah, and, it has a certain flow.
Yeah.
Yeah. How was it sounding
it
on your
side? Fastness in it. I think the low end in here it was a little bit too much. The you know you have this floor tom.
Yeah.
And on the right channel,
yeah,
and it's very hard to control that one.
True.
And actually, I heard this one on the heads, these monitors, and it was the first time that I really, the first system that really controlled this this track, because it's a very close mic'd track.
Well, there is a subtle price difference, I think.
Yeah, about 10 times, I guess.
Yeah. Shall we go to the Yamaha?
Yeah.
Maybe you can help them out. I'm going to switch to Jung now, because I have to swap the cables to the Yamaha amp. That's around 2,100 euros. So we're going to do a small step up in price and a small step down in watts, because the NAD has 150 watts per channel in 4 and in 8 ohm. It has optical coaxial phono stage and of course a plethora of line inputs. The Yamaha has 90 watts in 8 ohm, 150 or 160, that wasn't clear for me, in 4 ohms. It has phono MM and MC but no digital inputs. So I'm gonna switch to Jung, that's this one, and I'm gonna swap some cables. So,
yes.
What can you tell about Yamaha, Jung?
Well, we're very glad that Yamaha is back in business when it concerns on, you know, home audio. It seems like they have just revamped their old 80s, 90s amplifiers with VU meters, and I think they're almost the same. You know, the knobs and the look and feel is the same, and not surprisingly, they sound fantastic. I've heard the top model, I think it's a 5000 series, and they well, these are of course astonishing, but also the let's say the more fairly priced models are very, very good. And we also, you know, Jaap just mentioned the watts and the numbers and the figures, but they don't say that much. You know, it's an indication of what people, what amplifiers can do.
Yeah.
So don't be too sharp on, you know, I want a 100 watt amp or 80 watt.
No,
amp.
don't look at that. It's quite useless actually. I needed to switch on the Prima Luna.
Yeah, you can explain something about the damping factor.
Yeah, well, that's an interesting one, because an amplifier needs to give energy to the loudspeaker, but the unit in the loudspeaker, well, it moves, of course, but it needs to be controlled. So it needs to stop when it needs to stop. And one of the factors that is in play is the damping factor. How well does an amplifier control your loudspeaker? So it needs to see some sort of brick wall, and how well is that brick wall built? That's the damping factor. But the damping factor is completely dependable also on the speaker cable. The longer your speaker cable, the less your damping factor will be. I think a damping factor of 500 in most cases is enough for a decent loudspeaker. Some amplifiers have 1,000 or even higher than that. Yes, it does control a little bit better, but it can get dry. Yeah, I think a little bit too dry. So don't look at what
easily the damping factor and it's a collaboration between the speaker and the amp.
Yeah.
And mostly in active speakers, you see the
The wires are short,
not moving that much.
No, true, absolutely true. That's funny.
So that's really literally a damping factor. It,
yeah.
It controls. It really has a firm grip on the driver.
We need to play music, but there's one story I want to tell, because when I was testing the Hegel H590. Unfortunately, Hegel is not part of this test. They didn't deliver the amp. But when I was testing the H590, the first thing I noticed with complex tracks with a lot of bass is that the unit was hardly moving. It was striking to see how much control this amp has. It's a very good amplifier. But let's play some music. Chris Jones on the Yamaha. I'm gonna level it in the first 10 seconds, so don't be scared. Everything will be all right.
Call for senses. The boss wanna know what's going on. So Joseph and Mary hit the road with Mary nigh on 9 months gone. And you know we're talking about a hell of a walk, and they had no place to stay. They tried the inns and the hotels. The message was plain as day. You get no refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. No refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. And a baby boy they named Miguel. On the other side of the line it's heaven, on this side is a living hell. So you do what it takes, pick up stakes, and try to escape the drought. But when you get to the border, the INS, they got the welcome wagon out. You get no refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. No refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. Nothing in between. Religion to preach about loving your brother, but they run by the bowling green. Now there's a lot of folks are looking over the edge of that plate we've piled so high. When they all decide to come over the border, time to kiss it all goodbye. There'll be no refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. No refuge, and no respite, and no sanctuary here. No refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. No refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. No sanctuary here. No sanctuary here.
All right. So, Jung, totally different energy pattern, isn't it?
Yes.
Yes. For me, the NAD was more focused on mid-range. And this is like more, it's a little bit sweeter, sweeter in the mid and the upper ends, and the bass is less prominent.
It was more balanced.
I think it's more balanced.
I could hear clearly on these monitors.
Yeah.
It seemed more in control of things. You know, more grip on the music.
Could be.
But this is also a pretty heavy track, very bass, full of bass.
Yeah. Some say it's less engaging, like René. I think it can seem like that. I know what he means. The NAD grabs you because of the mid-range energy, and this is more calm. But it's
I think this is more where you can listen for hours.
Yeah, definitely.
And. Well, but let's listen to the other one, the other tracks, I'm very curious.
Let's go to Bach.
A very big difference, very, very,
very big. Big difference. Yeah, it's very, very different. I'll go to the Bach track. Wow. This was really good, I think. What do you think, Jung? I think the upper end of this Yamaha, just like the 2200, is just magical.
What can I say? If you listen, maybe the nasty, most nasty part of this track is it's a fugue, so it's a musical pattern that repeats after every eight bars, I think. And somewhere, I think, in 1 or 2 1 minutes, the double bass, the contrabass,
yeah,
is playing this tune, this line for a while. And on some systems, it simply vanishes between, you know, the piano and the drums.
Yep.
But here you could hear so clearly, yep, these lines.
Yeah.
So what does that say? It says that it is able to really display all the elements of the music.
Yeah, the different layers.
And that results in a better sound stage, in a better imaging.
Yeah.
And that I could clearly hear that. It was amazing. You know, it's YouTube.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Well, we do our best, Hume.
You know, these double bass patterns, it just stood out above the rest of the music, and that was amazing, because normally you have to have very expensive systems to get it out.
Yeah, true. I totally agree. Last song, opera.
Yeah.
All right, let's go. That's beneath here. Good. Okay. Wow. Jung? I think we can be...
Hello?
Yeah, you're back.
Sorry.
I think I'm we back. Can be pretty clear on this one.
Yeah.
I even forgot to turn off the track because YouTube doesn't like it when we play whole tracks, then we can get banned and they shut down the stream. I was just, wow. I have a weak spot for Yamaha. I like the AS series so much and they combine so incredibly well on the Focal Sopras. I don't know if you can, if you could hear it in your studio as well, and I don't know if you at home could hear the difference. I saw some very nice comments. The NAD for me was very good for the money. It's flexible, you can expand it with MDC modules, you can do whatever you want. It's powerful, it's controlled, but the Yamaha for me is just better balanced and more musical than the NAD. Yeah. That's at least what I could hear.
I think it's for the money, it's very close to high end quality.
Yes, it does have some high end.
Maybe it is high end.
What, sorry?
I don't know. What is high end? I don't know.
Yeah, that's
a
different question.
I think when you forget about what you just told me, that you just are immersed into the music and forget what you were doing, I think that's one of the elements of good quality sound reproduction.
Yeah.
And one of the readers suggested CD Dan. I think it's a very good suggestion. To Against Nature. Always very, very well recorded music. Complex. But I'm impressed by this. And maybe it's also, I don't know why, but somehow there is a synergy between the Focals and Yamaha.
Yeah, there definitely is. They really love each other. I'm going to swap to the Primare. So I'm going to give the stage to you, Jung. You can tell something about Primare?
Of course I can.
Okay, well.
Primare is Scandinavian. It's Swedish? Yeah, I think. Primare, it's not a very big company, but they have a very interesting lineup of amplifiers, from phono amplifiers to integrator to power amps. And streamers, and both their design and their sound-wise, they're really good value for money. It's not, I wouldn't say they're cheap, but they're not. You don't have to break the bank to own a Primare set. Also interesting is that they collaborate with another loudspeaker brand, where they have where they deliver the power amps and streaming units, so you can buy an active streaming speaker. I reviewed a phono preamp, the R35, the reference one.
Yeah, wow.
And we were so impressed by it.
Yeah.
You can see it on the video as well.
Yeah.
Have it as our reference phono preamp because for the money, or I think 1,500 euros. You can buy a better one, which is which has that much ways to adjust all the different parameters.
Mm.
So, we're really another brand to be fond of. A small brand,
yeah,
totally different than Yamaha, which is, you know, you can also buy a motorcycle of Yamaha. Here, you Primare doesn't make motorcycles.
No, not like Yamaha. There is some comments on your sound quality. Let's explain this. We had to build a complete new streaming setup in one day. So yeah, Jung's sound quality is not great, but he is connected with Skype. I had to grab out the Skype feed it into the stream. So this is the only way we could set up it quickly and decently and stably. So
I can try to to hook up a good mic later on, but it's very difficult to have other mics than these kind of. We have a plethora of mics here.
Yeah, I know, but I wouldn't know how to get the lip sync.
I can try maybe in the break, but we had to be quick.
Yeah,
so,
and people, please, we really try to do everything as good as possible, but it's technically a lot more complex than you think. This stream is incredibly complex to control and to get all the lip syncs correct and stuff like that, import external feeds. So we did the best we can. But let's focus on the amplifiers. The Primare is now connected. Jung explained about the philosophy and a little bit of the history. So let's get to music. Okay. By the way, the Primare is class D. It's 100 watts in 8 ohm. I think it's UCD or maybe Encore. I'm not sure. We'll type it in the fee in the written review somewhere early next week, but it's class D, this one, just like NAD, by the way. Let's start with Grace Jones.
Call for senses. The boss wanna know what's going on. So Joseph and Mary hit the road with Mary nigh home 9 months gone. And you know we're talking about a hell of a walk, and they had no place to stay. They tried the inns and the hotels. The message was plain as day. You get no refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. No refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. Home. One had his Juanita and a baby boy they named Miguel. On the other side of the line is heaven. On this side is a living hell. So you do what it takes, pick up stakes, and try to escape the drought. But when you get to the border, the INS, they got the welcome wagon out. You get no refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. No refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. In between religion, they preach about loving your brother, but they run by the bowling green. Now there's a lot of folks are looking over the edge of that plate we've piled so high. When they all decide to come over the border, time to kiss it all goodbye. There'll be no refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. No refuge and no respite and no.
before we go to the opera song for testing out spaciousness and stuff like that, I am quite surprised by this Class D amp. It doesn't sound anything like Class D. Yeah, the mid-range is a little bit more prominent than the Yamaha, but I think the Yamaha is just extremely smooth. But I think this Primare amp has the Class D pretty much nailed.
Are you sure it's Class D?
I'm absolutely sure.
If you wouldn't have told me, I wouldn't have believed it.
I'm pretty sure the i25 is Class D, but maybe you should look it up, because this doesn't sound anything like Class D. It's, wow.
No, the differences with the Yamaha were very subtle. Very subtle, not...
Fernand, it's Jacques Loucher, Little Fuge in G minor. We use it every stream because it's just a very good song for testing. But let's get to opera. But I just wanted to say this. It's wow. It's very smooth for a Class D amp. It's nice.
Thank you.
Okay. Holy shit, I didn't expect this. Yeah.
Yes.
Wow.
Yes, wow.
I absolutely didn't expect this because I was listening to it yesterday, checking it out and leveling a little bit already, doing the pre stuff to get this working today. And I must say I wasn't really impressed by the Primare, the songs I was listening to. But it, for me personally, it nailed this track. I think the Yamaha is softer. But I like to be drawn into the music, and I absolutely love the Yamaha. I bought the AS2200. I mean, how much can you love a product by buying it? But I there is something with this Primare and the vocals. Some one said it's too restrained. I didn't hear any restrainment in voices here. Did you notice something in the stream?
No. It was really one astonishment after the other.
Yeah, for me as well. It's like, wow, what the fuck? Yeah, I. Yeah, I like this one.
It's being blown away. I looked something up. Primary, it's class D. They call it ultra fast power device.
Jesus,
and
it's class D.
And they compare it to the Tesla insane mode in terms of energy highs and lows. They really do that in their white paper.
Okay.
Because what they say, what we have in common is an immediate transfer of torque, meaning power, to the wheel, providing them with instantaneous speed, producing virtually no heat or noise from their compact electric motors.
Okay.
So no distortion and no. So that's what they do in their amps.
Yeah,
so
yeah. Well,
Tesla for 2.5.
They did a good job.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So.
Okay.
And the nice thing about it is, just as the NAD, this is the base price, 2,500, and you can buy modules.
Yeah,
so
but
modules
for you guys, the Primare is 2,500 euros, but you get a streaming module in there. It's stock, delivered in the Primare i25 Prisma, but there are optional DAC modules, and they're not cheap. So keep that in mind. So the NAD does deliver a DAC in the 1800 euro stock version, but you don't get streaming. But if you want streaming, it's not as expensive as the modules for the Primare. I think Primare is just one class above the NAD in all terms. It sounds better, but it's also more expensive. So I think the NAD still performs very well in its class, because Yamaha is 2100 euros, but you don't get any digital inputs, nothing. So you need a DAC if you want to connect your television optically to your amp. So that's all you need to consider that in the price.
And we didn't test the streaming.
No.
Did we test?
No, it's Chromecast compatible. I don't know about Rune. Maybe you can check that out. And I'm gonna swap the amp to the Denon, the Denon 2500 NE. So the stage is yours, Jung.
Well, Denon, another Japanese A brand, let's say. Well, it's interesting to see that, you know, all these brands are having a lineup with integrated amps. Yamaha did it all analog. I just forgot how the Denon, if it's all analog or
no,
not.
It's also digital.
Also digital.
Yeah.
Well, we did the 1,000 euro Denon, and we were very, very impressed by it, because I think it's more or less the same setup, but with better parts, better components.
It is.
So I'm very curious if it really, if there's below, I think it was 600 euros or so.
Yeah.
And I remember that we said, well, okay, It might not be the most refined or one of the bunch, but it's so much fun to listen to. You know, it's just, you know, put on your dancing track and have a party, because it's so much oomph and power and so much fun to listen to.
Yeah, it's the same with this one.
So let's see. I think this one was about €600. It was
549. It was the PMA 800NE, and it had a DAC. It had everything, and it wasn't the most refined amp we had in the test. I think the Arcam eventually won in terms of refinement and price. But if you want something bang for the buck and just have fun, it's a very nice amplifier.
It even had a phono.
It had a phono stage, this one as well. It's class AB, it's 80 watts in 8 ohm, it has an optical, it has input, coaxial, headphone, and phono MM, so no MC.
That's the same.
Yeah.
It might be a little bit heavier than the other one.
Yeah.
In terms of power supply.
Oh yeah, definitely. It has a lot more power. Not in wattage, but in terms of capacity and power supply, it's a lot heavier.
Well, let's listen.
Yeah, let's check it out. I need to level it like I did before. Let's go.
Off my mic.
Yeah. Okay, let's go.
Call for senses. The boss wanna know what's going on. So Joseph and Mary hit the road, with Mary and I home 9 months gone. And you know we're talking about a hell of a walk, and they had no place to stay. They tried the inns and the hotels. The message was plain as day. You get no refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. No refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. Home. One had his Juanita and a baby boy they named Miguel. On the other side of the line is heaven. On this side is a living hell. So you do what it takes, pick up stakes, and try to escape the drought. But when you get to the border, the INS, they got the welcome wagon out. You get no refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. No refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. Snubbing in between. Religion to preach about loving your brother, but they run by the bowling green. Now there's a lot of folks are looking over the edge of that plate we've piled so high. When they all decide to come over the border.
Alright. I can't finish all the tracks because YouTube is warning me already, and so I need to cut off some tracks to keep the stream going. The comments say it all, I think. It's it has a lot of power and energy, and it really wants to keep you entertained. And I think it's extremely, extremely detailed. I think it's the most detailed amp up till now. What do you think?
No, well, I don't agree.
No? Oh, all right. Okay.
No, on this head, it doesn't sound that well, I would say. It's a little bit, the mid is very upfront.
Yeah, it is.
Mid-range?
It is.
And that seems to push away the other stuff. So
okay.
That disturbs me, and so it's difficult, but I recognize the sound signature of Denon. And of course, the other comments are your comments. It's
well, Eric says the Denon is more fun than the Yamaha. I do agree with the fun factor. It is more fun. So that's very, very well put, Eric. You definitely nailed that comment. But maybe you're right, Jung. But I was listening to the flageolets on the guitar. And it's very pronounced. And maybe that gives the illusion of detail. Wow, it's raining really hard. I hope you don't.
Yeah, here is also raining like cats and dogs.
Yeah, it's wow, and it's a flat roof, so I'm sorry if you hear all the rain now. But in the mid and in the heights, sounds for me is the Yamaha, and in the low, yeah. Well, most of the time it's a combination of more amps, and if you want it all, you just need to buy a more expensive amp. That's mostly how it goes. Even people, believe me, even at a level like Paslabs and Bryston and stuff like that, and Macintosh, you still hear stuff you like from other amps that you wish you had in your amp. It's all about balance and combination with the speakers. But I'm one kudos for the Driade speaker cable. It's I don't have the idea of having a cable between the amps and the speakers. It's a very nice cable. But let's get to the next track, because we're talking too much. It's time for Bach, Jung.
Yes.
All right. Thank you. right. To keep YouTube happy, to keep YouTube happy. I don't know. What do you think, Jung?
Well, it's very different.
Yeah, it's very different.
Actually, in the first place, I was pretty impressed by the way it. Bach sounded.
Yeah. Yeah.
But the last track, it just all fell apart because it was no bass control.
No.
There was. Well, actually, there was not much.
There was no soul.
But it's also because we know how it can sound.
Well,
it sounded very flat to me, very distant.
Yeah, true. For me, it lacked some sort of soul.
Yeah.
And it didn't grab me as much as I would like. I think it has some very nice characteristics, like the punch and the energy, but refinement. It was with the 800NE as well. It lacks some sort of refinement.
Yeah.
And you need refinement in that last song to keep, to give the voice her characteristics and glare and stuff. And the Primare really nailed that. I think the Yamaha as well, and the NAD does a better job as well.
Played on the vocal, we have two other reference speaker.
Yeah.
Because do you think on the B&W or?
I think it can control the B&W.
Sorry?
I think it can control the B&W with ease, but the B&W is even more critical on refinement because of the diamond tweeter. And the vocal is a little bit sweeter in terms of matching. So it's easier to match than a B&W. So I think it's even harsher on the Denon than the Focal.
Yeah,
let's go to the... Well, you can choose. Do we grab the Prima Luna or do we take the Advanced Paris pre and power amp? I give you 20 seconds to decide. So, Prima Luna or Advanced Acoustic Preamp Power Amp? You choose.
Prima Luna, Advanced. It's a tie.
Oh.
Okay. Let's do Prima Luna.
Jung, do you have a coin?
Yes, I just did it, the coin.
Yeah? And?
Prima Luna.
Prima Luna it is. So, you entertain them, you tell them about tubes.
Prima Luna, Dutch, isn't
yeah.
it? Yeah, it's Dutch.
It is.
The only tube, or vacuum tube amplifier of the bunch. Actually, I haven't heard Prima Luna that much. I think only in a shop once, like a demo. So I'm very curious about it. I just happened to hear yesterday a very, very nice tube amplifier, an Italian one who normally makes headphone amplifiers, but it's very impressive. There also with tubes, we have some guitar amplifiers with tubes as well. There's always the thing on which tube you choose. You have the famous Philips tubes, you have the three Russian 300B tubes, and they all are different sound wise. But the main thing, the main nice thing about tube amplifiers compared to transistor amplifiers is the way they handle distortion. Because they have, inherent on the technology, they do something with distortion that we perceive as nice. With transistors, it's more a either or story. And that's why transistors are in general perceived as more harsh or neutral when not treated correctly. Maybe the same as class D. And the other thing about tubas that they don't have that much power, but at the same time, because of their topology, their technology, they're very well able to drive difficult speakers. The damping factor of tube amplifiers are pretty high, to say that. So yep. That's, you know, it's a different technology, so let's see. And in general, they are perceived to sound very musical, to be very yep. tolerant to distortion.
True.
And it can become hot, which is in these days a disadvantage.
I just connected it. It's really warm. There is one thing with Prima Luna that's very different. Two things, actually. It has a detection system for tubes that are starting to degrade. So you get a light on... with in front of the tube that is degrading, and there is an auto bias system inside. So if you replace the tube, you switch it on, it automatically biases the whole system. So you don't have to really match the tubes, and if one is starting to degrade a little bit, it compensates for that. So that's a really nice system.
Okay.
That's pretty unique. It's a Dutch brand, like Jung said. It's built in China, but under good conditions. So no slavery or anything. That's, I think, very important to know. And the designer is still in Holland and is still controlling all the stuff that is needed to keep the quality up. But we can talk about Prima Luna endlessly. I've never ever heard a Prima Luna in this listening room. Yesterday for the first time, of course, to check everything. So for me it's also a surprise. I hope you like it, and I hope I like it. I have no clue whatsoever. Let's go, Jung.
Call for senses. The boss wanna know what's going on. So Joseph and Mary hit the road with Mary nigh on 9 months gone. And you know we're talking about a hell of a walk, and they had no place to stay. They tried the inns and the hotels. The message was plain as day. You get no refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. No refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. Home, 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 home. Juan had his Juanita and a baby boy they named Miguel. On the other side of the line it's heaven, on this side is a living hell. So you do what it takes, pick up stakes, and try to escape the drought. But when you get to the border, the INS, they got the welcome wagon out. You get no refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. No refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. Have nots, and almost nothing in between. Religion to preach about loving your brother, but they run by the bowling green. Now there's a lot of folks are looking over the edge of that plate we've piled so high. When they all decide to come over the border, time to kiss it all goodbye. There'll be no refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. No refuge, and no respite, and no sanctuary here. No refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. No refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. No sanctuary here.
Okay. Well, yeah. This is a hard one, Jung. I don't think...
Sorry, I missed,
Yeah.
Yes, now I'm on.
Sorry?
No, I didn't hear the last 10 seconds of what you said.
No, I was just starting. It had some very nice elements, and it had some not so nice elements in this system. I think after the brute force of all the Class A, B amps, this is so immensely different. But for me, it lacked the punch in the low frequencies, and if your bass is not right, all the rest is just not in balance.
Yeah.
And I heard it with every song that the bass is just not spot on. It was a bit, yeah, I don't know, it lacked the glow and it lacked the definition of, let's say,
of course, that's strange for vacuum tubes. I think it's the match of the speaker. I think with a Wharfdale or a Wharfdale Linton or so, would sound much more.
I think
with a horn speaker.
Yes, I think you're right. I think if you match it with another speaker, I think the Focal may be just not the right choice. It's not a hard speaker, the Focal, and I didn't have any issues with combining with other amps, but maybe a tube just doesn't work on this loudspeaker.
I think when we it's maybe not fair to compare this one, you know, it's really odd one out.
Yeah, it
one,
is definitely tube. It's only 40 watts, remember that.
Do a tube shootout.
Yeah, let's just say, you know, this one is too different. Oh, yeah, you're back. You put me on hold, man. You're ghosting me.
Coming phone call somehow. I don't know.
Maybe more music is hacking you now. Is hacking our feed. No,
let's be fair. I think we have to look for, because I know. This is a very good brand, and they deserve a better review.
It
doesn't work or so.
I think you're right. I think you're right. Let's do a tube shootout. This was the old one out.
We have a tube shootout. We have the JBL horn tweeter.
In your studio, of course.
We have it here. But what surprises me was it didn't engage me into the music.
No,
that was the main, and with components of such quality as what we're reviewing right now, it has to be the match. You cannot only blame that amplifier.
No, absolutely not. I think you're right. We should try another loudspeaker. Let's check if it combines better with our DALI. That's a very easy speaker to drive.
If we can keep this one for a while.
Yeah.
And,
we'll get back to this one. Tube is just not the combination with our vocals, I think. But who knows? Maybe it is. Let's get to the Advance Acoustic. Advance Paris. Yeah. You can tell something about Advance.
Let's maybe. We can try a break, and I can maybe try to swap a microphone on the.
A small break.
Or do you want it to go on? It's 5 minutes.
5 minutes.
Yeah, three. I don't know.
Okay.
Put some nice music on.
I'll put on some music. Let's first swap to the Advance.
Yeah. Okay. I'll tell something about Advance if I can find something, because. I thought I would do it in the break.
But we only have two amps left, you. it's.
You're racking up the Advance?
Yeah, I'm gonna rack up the Advance, and after that, it's only the name, and then we're finished.
Okay, then we'll just finish.
Yeah, and then we'll take a break. Okay, Advanced Acoustic it is. French.
Yes. Advanced Paris. Wait a minute. I have to get some XP500. I had it somewhere, but I lost it. Well, Advance is a brand that also we also tested it in our sub-1000 amplifiers. So Venture, very interesting brand, which had also in my opinion, a very impressive design. They all look, you know, with these blue VU meters As I recall, it also surprised us positively in our test of the, let's say, the below 1000 integrated amplifiers. We were pretty surprised by this brand, and it just like Denon's, it has a plethora of in and outputs, digital, analog, USB. Balanced in and yeah, I think, is it also made in France?
I think it is. Let's check. I don't but this is the top of the line AB.
Yeah.
It's the XA160 and the X. Let's see. Well, the X60P of the XP60, yeah. I think it was. 160 watts in 8 ohms and.
Wolfson duck and.
240 in 4 ohms.
AKM receiver.
Yeah. Yeah, it has everything. It has even has a phono stage and a headphone output and stuff like that. So it's a very complete pre and power combination. 45 watts in class A, and I put it in high bias. So this is the best it can sound. I think the high bias setting is better, but it gets hot. And well, if you need the power, then you should put it to low bias, because then you have more power in class AB.
It's enough for these speakers.
It's enough, definitely. Yeah. So maybe the Prima Luna just was borderline in power. Could be.
Mm-hmm.
Could be.
Okay,
let's switch on the Advance Acoustic pre and power. We'll start off with No Sanctuary Here.
Senses, the boss wanna know what's going on. So Joseph and Mary hit the road with Mary and I home 9 months gone. And you know we're talking about a hell of a walk, and they had no place to stay. They tried the inns and the hotels. The message was plain as day. You get no refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. No refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. Home. One had his Juanita and a baby boy they named Miguel. On the other side of the line it's heaven. On this side is a living hell. So you do what it takes, pick up stakes, and try to escape the drought. But when you get to the border, the INS, they got the welcome wagon out. You get no refuge, no respite and no sanctuary here. No refuge, no respite and no sanctuary here. Nothing in between. Religion to preach about loving your brother, but they run by the bowling green. Now there's a lot of folks are looking over the edge of that plate we've piled so high. When they all decide to come over the border, time to kiss it all goodbye. There'll be no refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. No refuge, and no respite, and no sanctuary here. No refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. No refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. No sanctuary here. No sanctuary here.
Wow. Well, that's a big difference. That's a big difference. And it doesn't prove that the Prima Luna is not a good amp. It just proves that the Prima Luna really didn't match with the Focal. Remember that. Like Jung said, we're going to do a tube shootout. Pick a decent speaker that combines well with tubes. And then we'll see again how that works out. But this Advance, yeah, I think it's very well. It you're on mute.
Well,
yeah, that's better.
Yeah,
it's complete.
What is also what is also, you know, the, I should remembered the with the Prima Luna, the first track, Chris Jones, was pretty much okay.
Yeah,
the first track condition was. And now I'm definitely sure that I never wanted to hear audiophile music again, because this was the only track that's from audiophile label.
Yeah.
And these songs always sound good.
Almost always,
you know,
sound good.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's a voice and guitar.
Yeah, true.
You know, and that's
true.
That's on every system it sounds even good on Sonos. No more audiophile.
No,
stuff.
Let's agree on that. Let's get to the next track, and see how that works out. Thank you. Yeah, I saw some comments about the mid-range. I agree. It's a bit warm in the mid-range, I think.
Yeah.
A tiny bit warm. And maybe not as detailed as the Primare or Yamaha or NAD. I think it's more pleasant in the long run than the Denon. That was a bit prominent sometimes.
Well, it reminds me of the Denon, actually. And I remember it was the same thing with the Subtitle review. We had the same...
Yeah, it does have some similarities, but I think the Advanced Acoustic is less detailed and maybe in the long run more pleasant to listen to. But I think Advanced Paris has gone for connectivity, looks, and an amp that sounds decent on a lot of loudspeakers. Because it does sound good. I think it sounds good, but if you want more refinement and want to get rid of some connectivity stuff, then a Yamaha or a Primare is the step up.
Yeah,
I think that's my opinion.
This one is impressive in terms of, you know, look at my system.
Yeah, yeah, the blue lights and stuff like that. It's very nice. I forgot to switch. I'm sorry. Would it do the same if it's in AB instead of A? I wanted to check that out. Shall we set the bias to low and see what it does? We have time.
Yeah.
Yeah? I'm gonna switch.
Oh, yes. I thought the AB comparison, but class A or class B. Yeah.
See what it does. Okay. No Chris Jones. We're gonna do the Buck track again in low bias and see what it does. Okay. Wow, that's different. Okay, dat Dat is een hele makkelijke keuze in dit geval.
I did not hear a difference.
Yeah, you heard nothing, Jung. No. I know. Nothing. You're completely deaf. Holy shit, that's a big difference. Did you hear the difference, Jung?
Yeah, who could not hear the difference?
Yeah, well, the chat exploded as 10 seconds after I pressed play. Yeah, you can choose high or low bias. Well, I think low bias is...
How can you explain this? Yeah.
Well, I think in low bias, you either have a transistor to amplify the top end and a transistor to amplify the low end. And you just get more power if you... verdelen.
Divide?
Yeah, if you divide... No, not divide. That's if you use more transistors, you have more power. And essentially, you just used a couple of transistors to do the whole cycle. And now you combine the transistors to separate the top and the low end. But holy shit, that's a big difference. I think it sounded so much better in low bias. Just less muddy, more power, more control. Well, that's a good advice. Thank you. I'm glad we swapped it over because now it's a completely different league.
We have one track.
Yeah, we have one track left. I was looking at the distribute. Thank you. Yeah. To distribute the power over more transistors. That's the thing I wanted to say. Yeah, we have Opera. Last song, and then we go to the name. And the name is the most expensive one. It's the new XS3. But we'll talk about that later. First, music.
Thank you.
Wow. Okay. We have something to celebrate, Jung. Jung is still in the music. I said we have something to celebrate. You're still on mute. Yeah, there you are.
Tell me.
Well, YouTube is really warning us now. We have one amp to go. I hope we're still gonna stay online. I'm sorry if we get disconnected. I can't help it. I think our streams are so good in quality that they think we're a radio station. But we have something to celebrate. We have 100 viewers online on our stream. So thank you all for watching. I think that's a big compliment. And thank you all for staying on the stream. It's a long one. But
2 hours.
2 hours already, yeah. Yeah, we have one amp to go. That's the name.
Yeah.
I think this amp has two characteristics. I think it's so much better in low bias that for me it's a no-brainer. In class A it's just muddy, undefined, and not very dynamic. And in class AB low bias it's just a very, very musical sounding nice amplifier. That's my opinion.
Yes.
It's easy.
Well, I think we and the readers also reacted on it. We don't have to add something more on it. I think it's an amazing amp.
Yeah.
It has much control, and it is as if there are two amplifiers. And I'm wondering in what setup the A class A setting would work.
Maybe
actually,
with a high sensitive speaker, could work. It could work.
Yeah.
Or a very bright one. If you have an old Focal, maybe even a very old Beryllium Focal, there you.
Or a Russell K.
Russell K. Also, yeah. They tend to be very bright. Jeffrey is on the stream. Maybe Jeffrey can say something about it. He tested a Russell K recently, and what I read is that it tends to be bright. And then the class A setting can work, but it's still a very high sensitive speaker without any damping inside. So that could match very well. But on this system, the class AB setting low bias is way better. So I'm gonna connect the name amplifier. The last one.
Well,
you can
name.
Say something about name. What's in the name?
Yap was at the factory.
Yeah.
Of course, before COVID times, and
definitely
was also impressed by the way they do things. And Name and Lin are actually one of the same kind. You know, they're brands that have their own philosophy, their own connections. You know, Name, as one of the few brands, has DIN connectors, which drives people like us crazy. They still deliver amps and the stuff with DIN as this one. The Nate series is it's the XS3. XS2 is there for 2 years, and the Nate series. We like it pretty much because it's of course high end with. Hefty prices, but it's payable. And we saw this, I think, at a show. Yeah, XS3. And Name is wonderfully built, sturdy. It has a good power supply. They have excellent after sales, and especially if you stay within the Name family, the Name ecosystem, you are set. And it's very well carried out. Well, this one has both a class A headphone output. It has a phono preamp only for moving magnets, but it also has a power outlet, 24 volts for the Name phono stage, which is very nice. So you don't need an extra phono stage for that. you have the Alps volume meter, or the volume control. Alps in this name, oh, sorry, the Neve thing, you also have a Alps one, and you see this on mixing consoles. And it's very sturdy, refined, precise, no noise, and you lose no gain in that. Well, it's here. It's priced 2,795 euros here in Europe, so it's slightly the most expensive one. It has 2 times 70 watts in 8 ohms,
yep.
And 2 times 100 watts in 4 ohms. It has. It doesn't have digital inputs. No, only analog inputs. But that's because NAME has its own digital streamers and all the other stuff. Did I forget something about it?
One thing I want to add is that the philosophy of NAME, I was busy connecting it, and there are a couple of things that are very odd with NAME. One is that they swap left and right on the back. So you really need to pay attention when connecting stuff to a NAME amplifier, because they swap left and right, because they say the audio rack needs to be on the side and not in the middle. Another thing is that their philosophy is big, big, big power supplies. So all NAME amplifiers or devices are very heavy, and that's because of the power supply. This is the first amp in the range that you can actually connect an external power supply to, so you can upgrade this one, and it's very, very audible. And the other thing is that their PCB boards are always completely disconnected mechanically to keep vibrations away from all the components inside, and that's a clever thing to do, because resonances can eventually generate energy, and that energy will be audible. So that's another thing. Whew, I'm a bit short on breath, because I needed to get behind the NAME amplifier, and I wasn't really looking forward to that, because it's warm and it's not very comfortable connecting all the cables back there. Let's play some music. So this is the most expensive one in the range. But yeah, let's see if it's audible, shall we? Yeah. Let's start with, yeah, The Last Time You, No Sanctuary Here. After this, we're never going to use it again. Shite. Sorry about this. I need to check the cables.
These call for senses. The boss wanna know what's going on. So Joseph and Mary hit the road, with Mary nigh on 9 months gone. And you know we're talking about a hell of a walk, and they had no place to stay. They tried the inns and the hotels, the message was plain as day. You get no refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. No refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here.
Wow, okay.
Yeah, I put the microphone.
Yeah, wacht even. Yeah.
call for census. The boss wanna know what's going on. So Joseph and Mary hit the road, with Mary nigh home 9 months gone. And you know we're talking about a hell of a walk, and they had no place to stay. They tried the inns and the hotels, the message was plain as day. You get no refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. No refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. Juanita and a baby boy they named Miguel. On the other side of the line it's heaven, on this side is a living hell. So you do what it takes, pick up stakes and try to escape the drought. But when you get to the border, the INS, they got the welcome wagon out. You get no refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here. No refuge, no respite, and no sanctuary here.
Alright, this is completely different, Jung. We have two tracks to go, and it's getting warm in here. The rain cooled it down a little bit, but it's getting pretty warm. But I'm glad it's only two tracks left. I think this name has a very nice, smooth sounding rhythmic characteristic. I don't know if you agree.
You can, yeah. Well, yeah. What you could, it really grabs the focus by the balls, to say.
Yeah, definitely.
Very authoritative.
Let's grab them by the balls. Yeah. It does have a lot of control on the vocal, but honestly, people, a name and vocal work together. So I would be very, very surprised if this didn't work well. But it's 2,800 euros. And it makes you think. Like, you know, it's expensive. There's no streaming. It's analog only, just like the Yamaha. And the Yamaha matches very well on the Focal as well. But it's very different, the Yamaha and the name. Very different.
Very, yeah.
It's completely, yeah.
I had to listen to more tracks than this one.
Yeah, let's grab the next one.
Something.
But YouTube is complaining pretty much now.
Yeah? Oh. What do they say? Short. Stop mics. Thank you.
Yeah. Well, I guess you guys have heard this. It's wow, it's really well. It's very controlled, and all the different layering is so well defined and easy to dissect. It you can just grab one part out of the music and follow that, and I think for me that's a high-end quality. Some people say it's just a very good match. Yeah, true. Name and vocal go really well together. But my experience with the Sopra 1 is that it's a pretty easy speaker to match. You heard it on the Yamaha, it matches well. You heard it on the Primary, it matches well. You heard it on the NAD, it went very well. The Advance also. And the two amps that didn't go as well as the rest, maybe, is the Denon and the Primaluna. The Primaluna is a tube amp, so maybe it just doesn't work on a Focal. Could be the case. I think this is a very nice amp, but it's the most expensive one. Keep that in mind. In terms of functionality, the Advance just kills the name, of course. Well, how was it on your end, Jung?
It was as if I had I was listening to the source here.
Yeah.
It was amazing. I know this track pretty well.
Yeah.
And it was so detailed and so natural, actually. And at the same time, so much punch.
Yeah.
Yeah,
the bass kick.
It really is a step up in amplification, I think. I would say it's worthwhile the money, but it's...
Me too. But
I don't need amps. I don't have to pay it. But,
exactly. Still 2,800 euros.
I would say less is more, but I could imagine also that you would like a system with everything on board.
Yeah, same. Like you said, it's not our money. I think it's also worthwhile the money, but if you just want something that's like a hub, you need an NAD or a Primare. And if you want purity and less is more, a Yamaha or a Name is a good choice. And if you want an impressive box...
the differences between Primare and this one were not that big in my memory, but I couldn't...
No, but you're right. The Primare does have some characteristics of the Name. It's the same punch and control. And the Name also, it's very rhythmic and impressive in terms of control. Yeah, you're right. They do have some similarities. Well, let's grab the last track, Opera, and then we're gonna conclude, okay?
Thank you.
Well, at least we survived the YouTube block. Cool. That was goosebumps good, I think. Yeah, someone was asking about all the amps. It's in the description and on the website, alphaaudio.nl and alphaaudio.net. You can check the news article in which we mentioned this stream. So just, yeah, Eric says a tier again. Yeah, almost. It's amazing, this combination. And this
Rene was right. He said the difference is in the last track, in that whistle.
Yeah.
Whistle thing.
Yeah.
And every amp displays this thing differently.
True. Yeah.
And he is very right about that.
Yeah.
Because it's a very subtle sound.
Yeah.
But not every amp can reproduce it correctly.
No, it's funny. It's that small thing. I don't know what it is exactly, but some define it perfectly well.
It's a effect, you know. It's in all this in the EDM music, or in the EDF, all this digital. It's a chirp sound.
Yeah.
But there were amps where it more looked like a door that was, you know, not oiled enough.
Yeah.
And it should be a very high up chirp whistle, I don't know, ish thing. And yeah, you should listen to it when you listen to the stream back.
Yeah.
I would advise you to pay attention to that one.
Yeah.
Thank you for the advice.
Okay. Yeah, it's a good point. It's that exact effect that makes or breaks the song, maybe. Not completely, but the voice is also very dynamic, and when she goes full throttle, I always get a little bit emotional. I really like this song. It just grabs me. I think, yeah. But if it doesn't have the dynamics, the system, then it's just so boring and flat. Anyway, we're gonna round up. It's been 2 hours. Well, 2.5. To be exact, I was counting on 3 hours for this complete test, so we're still on schedule. But I'm getting hungry. I don't know about you, and I need coffee. What was one of the highlights for you, Jung?
Well, I expected the name to be one of the best, so that was an expected highlight. I was surprised by Primar. Really surprised.
Yeah, me too.
Also Yamaha was a kind of I hope that they would deliver, and they delivered.
Yeah, true.
It was and you know, in this category there is no better, worse.
No.
It's luckily it's all details. I think when I would have the money, I would buy them all, maybe, and have for every day in the week I have a different one.
Yeah, that would be ideal.
And I think Denon is really party time. Really, it's a fun amplifier.
It's a really fun amplifier. Yeah.
Advance is really French. You know, it looks it's like a Citroën. It's, you know, it has all the facilities, all the connections. It looks good. It has a few meters. I think Prima Luna, it deserves
Definitely deserves a second chance.
A review on tubes.
Yeah.
And NAD.
Well, don't forget, it's 700 euros cheaper. 700.
Yes.
That's a lot.
But you can hear that.
You do hear that. But I had two weird models. We always, you and I, most of the time we start to make a list, and then we think, what are we going to add to make a point? Well, I wanted to show you guys what the difference is in 700 euros In terms of sound, well, the NAD is the cheapest of the bunch. You can hear that, but it's still a very good amp, I think. And Prima Luna was the other oddball by using tubes. Well, that was a mistake on my part. I think we should do a tube shootout and match a better speaker with it. Was my mistake, not Prima Luna's. I think Ricardo has my top three as well. I think Name grabbed me the most, but it's the most expensive amp. It's 1100, no, it's €1,000 more than the NAD. Yeah, that's a lot of money. I think for me, then it's Yamaha and Primare, maybe on equal level. The funny thing is, the Name and the Yamaha are both the purest of the bunch by doing analog only. I think Primare did an excellent job on integrating digital in this amp. It's impressive how good it sounds. And then I think Advance is for fun. It looks great. Big blue LEDs on the front. It sounds very good still in low bias in this setup. And I think Denon is a party amp. It's just a lot of fun. It's very dynamic and it's fun to listen to, but it's not the most refined. But it was the same in our €1,000 shootout, Jung.
Yeah.
It's a lot of fun. It's not the most refined, but you get people dancing with that amp. And if you're looking for a fun amp, the 2500NE is a very fun amp. It's so.
It is. Yeah.
Some people are asking about Arkham and Musical Fidelity. Well, you know, we asked all of them. But some just don't want to be compared live online. Think Rotel, think Arkham, think Musical Fidelity. There are some brands that just don't like this kind of testing. But I think the longer we do this kind of testing and the more you like this kind of testing, the more chance we get by doing a bunch online. I think this kind of testing is very transparent and very honest. But some brands are scared, I think. But we did ask all of them, so know that.
You suggested some tunes, but this time YouTube was really monitoring us. So there are tracks which you cannot play for even 5 seconds, and we cannot know which one it is. So
no,
we did not dare to take the risk of YouTube shutting us the stream down.
Yeah.
So sorry about that.
Because yeah, we can get
that. Some nice suggestions on also classical tracks, other tracks.
Yep.
And we'll get into that, but it's always a cat and mouse game with YouTube.
Yes, sometimes they ban us, sometimes they don't. Maybe if this is a big success and we can set up our own streaming server and distribute it that way we don't get banned. But it's a whole complex game of rights and screening and stuff like that, but we're not gonna bore you with that. I hope you like this test.
I was surprised how it how it sounded remotely.
How did it sound
in Ireland? I know the speakers is the set, and you could easily hear differences.
Is it really audible?
Yeah, it is.
Okay, cool.
And not only, I also listen to it on headphones and, of course, the big headphones. But and, of course, this setup here is quite insane. But of course, there was also a viewer who said, okay, I'm listening to this on my laptop speakers. Well, that's kind of a challenge. So
I don't think it's audible on laptop speakers.
To hear a difference, but no. If you use decent headphones or you connect it to your stereo at home, you could hear it. But it was a nice test.
Yeah, It was. I had a lot of fun. One of the viewers said I had to grab you from out of space. You didn't deserve a punishment like this. I totally agree. Next time Jung will be sitting next to me. We had to legally do it remotely. But the good part is that Jung knows our listening room and he can compare the experiences here with his experiences remote. So now we have a very, very good benchmark and proof whether it's audible or not. And did you hear the characteristics of this room, Jung?
Well, I hear... microphone. I hear that the room is very well... it's a, let's say, a very dry room.
Yeah, it is. But you know it's a very dry room.
But I could hear instantly when testing earlier this morning, I could hear the vocals.
Ah, cool. Yeah, yeah. Well, that's cool.
You know, this the tweeter, it has a characteristically way of displaying the high of the high frequency. Sorry, I'm also a little bit tired, so yeah. The words cannot do that come out. So
it's been a long
easily.
One.
But they have a characteristic.
Yeah.
Especially in the high frequencies.
They do.
And that's clearly audible here.
Cool. So. Well, thanks all. We're going to leave you to it. We're going to have some lunch have some coffee. And after that, I'm going to go home and have some weekend. I'm going to clean this up on Monday. I'm not going to do it today. I'm also quite tired, honestly. Will this video be available today or tomorrow on YouTube? Yes, YouTube will leave it online if all goes well. And if not, we have a recording on our server, lossless. I'm going to try to take out all the clips and put them in the review. But that's a lot of work. Don't expect that
Monday,
to be online next week. Because then I need to edit 3 hours of music. And that's going to be a whole bunch of work. But if all goes well, you can watch back this live stream. No problem at all. So keep fingers crossed and hope YouTube doesn't kick it off. But thank you all for watching. I had a lot of fun today. It was a very busy stream. We had a lot of activity on the chat. That's good. Thank you. And spread the word. We're going to do this once a month. Every second Friday we have a Q&A, and I hope every month an interview with some interesting people as well. So stay tuned, subscribe to the YouTube channel to keep up to date, and follow Alpha Audio online. Appreciate it. Thank you very much. Jung, thank you
Bye.
For tuning in remotely.
Enjoy your weekend.
Yes, enjoy all. Thank
stay
you.
Safe.
Okay, bye-bye.